Hello, my name is Ilkka Varjos. I come from the company Canatu. I'm here today to tell you about our freestanding CNT membrane technology. I hope this talk inspires you to think how our technology could help you in your project and in the applications that you are working on. Canatu is a nanocarbon company, so we are dedicated to developing and manufacturing of the most advanced carbon nanotubes and transforming industries with that. We are currently working commercially in two different domains, in automotive and in the semiconductor domain. In automotive, our solutions are touch sensors and transparent heating elements. And in the semiconductor industry, the solutions are CNT freestanding membranes. Our history is such that we span out from Technical University of Helsinki in 2004. And in 2008, we got our seed funding, so our operational journey started then. Our headquarters are in Finland. And from the beginning, IPR has been very important for our existence. We have more than 100 patents in 23 different families, as well as long list of trade secrets. And this IPR is centered around the material and the ways of synthesizing and depositing the material, as well as a range of different applications. We have been in mass production in automotive industry since 2015, and we started mass production in the semiconductor domain this year. Financially, we have very good backing. We have VC firms and as well as strategic partners such as Denso, 4C and 3M funding our company. So then about the freestanding CNT membranes themselves. First, a little bit of background. So as everybody probably very well knows, it's increasingly difficult to keep up with the Moore's law. For instance, EUV lithography is a prime example. EUV lithography is by far the most complicated lithographic process developed this far. And at the same time, it's increasingly difficult to create these smaller and smaller transistors free from defects, so keep the yields high up. And also what is becoming clear is that silicon is reaching its physical limits and new disruptive materials are needed in order to keep us going on with the Moore's law. And carbon nanotubes, they hold a lot of promise as a replacement for traditional materials such as silicon. For instance, in the EUV pellicle application, EUV pellicle being the sophisticated particle filter that is placed on top of the EUV mask. CNTs have the potential to be more optically better, for instance, more transparent than the silicon pellicles that are currently used in this application. To give you an introduction to these properties of our CNT, freestanding CNT membranes, I will just first show you a short video before I dig deeper in my presentation to different aspects of our membranes.
The biggest impact can be made on the smallest scale. Canatu CNT membrane is the world's thinnest and strongest freestanding membrane. It's a random network with a very small pore size, capable of filtering particles down to the nanoscale. Despite being so thin, the CNB membrane is exceptionally strong because of the high aspect ratio of the individual CNB tubes, unequaled by any other material. CNB membranes are robust to endure industrial handling and processing, featuring very low pressure when the flow rate increases, and have extraordinary high heat resistance of up to 1500 degrees Celsius without breaking or decomposing. CMV membranes provide extremely high light transmission and a low scattering of light. And they come in multiple sizes, shapes, and thicknesses. Such membranes are used in semiconductor and space applications, where high optical transmission, durability, and high heat tolerance are critical. With the smallest dimensions, you can create the biggest benefits for your business.
So why does Canatu's carbon nanotubes outperform the other CNTs? So there are several companies in the world making carbon nanotubes. And the traditional way of making carbon nanotube-based films is to disperse them into liquid and then with a certain coating method make a film such as a freestanding film. And that is a challenge because when you disperse these carbon nanotubes onto a liquid, they tend to bundle up, they form these flocks. And to prevent this, you need to use processes like ultrasonication. And this ultrasonication makes defects to these CNTs and also break them into shorter sections. And after that sonication, you need to add materials like surfactants in order to prevent them from bundling up again when the sonication ends. So these surfactants, they absorb to the surfaces of these CNTs and this way contaminate the CNTs. And even if these surfactants are able to be removed afterwards from the film, the damage is already done because the carbon nanotubes are shorter and defected, and this impairs the properties of the film, such as mechanical properties. So we have skipped that step altogether, and in our unique dry process, we nucleate the carbon nanotubes in a reactor, and directly underneath the reactor, we deposit these carbon nanotubes onto a substrate, so make this film. So this deposition process is dry, it happens in the room atmosphere. And the result of this process is that the tubes are cleaner, they are longer, and there are less defects. So you have better properties like better electrical conductivity and better mechanical properties. And we have created the deep technical know-how on this process and the ways we can optimize and modify the process and process output to have a different kind of CNT membrane structures and CNT structures, and I will go a little bit deeper to that later on in my presentation. And of course, as I mentioned earlier, this know-how is protected by patents and trade secrets that we have. So as you saw in the video, this results in a very truly remarkable properties when it comes to this freestanding film. So the freestanding film is extremely thin, it's like less than 20 nanometers in thickness, but it's still mechanical robust. For instance, it has a relatively high tensile strength for its dimensions, and it's very flexible, and the structure is porous, so you can use it to filter particles down to nanoscale. Also, this membrane is very heat resistant, so you can put this membrane into up to 1500 degrees Celsius in a vacuum environment without damaging the network. And also the network has very high electrical conductivity. Perhaps most importantly, this structure has very high transparency, especially in the EUV and X-ray wavelengths, the transmission is more than 97%. And also it's optically has a very advanced optical characteristics, as it doesn't scatter light and it doesn't reflect light, or at least those values are extremely low compared to materials such as silicon. Then I will give you a couple of examples of applications that our material and this freestanding film structure can be potentially applied to. One application, which I've been referring to earlier also in this talk, is freestanding CNT membrane as an EUV pellicle. So this EUV pellicle, as mentioned, is this sophisticated particle filter on top of an EUV mask, which can let through EUV light, and this way enable the printing of this EUV process without defects. And our material has this very high EUV transmission and low flare and reflection. So these properties enable potentially like higher throughput from the machine because the exposure times are shorter, but also better precision as the light doesn't get scattered and the print is more defined. Also, what is needed in this application is very high heat resistivity because of this high energy of this EUV laser source. The pellicle heats up to above 500 degrees Celsius. Also, the material has to be robust enough that it can endure this, mechanically this process, for instance, the venting of the vacuum pumping of the EUV scanner. And high uniformity is of course required so that the print is consistent all across the wafer. Another interesting example is X-ray optical filter. So in this application, our material is used as a kind of lens that cuts all the other wavelengths, but also only lets X-ray through. And this is something that is utilized in an X-ray telescope. This X-ray telescope is shot into space, and in there it's detecting the celestial objects at the outermost areas far into space. As the celestial objects, they emit and reflect these X-rays, and the structure is such that our CNTs are coated with this certain metal. And for this reason, in this picture, you can see that this freestanding film is reflective, and this metal is cutting these other wavelengths, and our CNT layer is letting X-rays through to the sensor. And the key properties that are required in this application is high transparency, robustness to mechanical vibrations as this system is shot into space, and also chemical inertness. And this is something we are working together with the European Space Agency and targeting launch of the telescope called Athena. Then I will move to certain modifications that we can do to our membrane. So it's not just one type of freestanding film we can produce, but we can modify the CNT and the membrane structure in various different ways, which some of them I will explain in the coming slides. One way of altering the structure is removing the metallic catalyst, because you need this metallic catalyst to grow the CNTs in the synthesis process. So by default, those remain inside these carbon nanotube structures and in this membrane. So we have developed this process where you can remove this catalyst while not damaging the CNTs themselves. On the left side, you can see a CNT structure, this membrane under a microscope, and these white dots, those are the metallic catalyst particles. And on the right side, you can see these CNTs after this catalyst removal process. And you can see that you have these cocoons here, these kind of carbon shells that once had this catalyst inside, but now are empty because the catalyst has been removed. Another way to alter the CNTs is to dictate the amount of walls that these CNTs have. We have a process to make single wall and also multi-wall tubes, and here are some examples. So here you see an image of a single wall carbon nanotube. Here's a double wall, triple wall, and even five wall. And this, of course, changes the properties of the network quite drastically and gives new opportunities. you can, for instance, like treat the membrane in a way that you would break these outer cells while the inner tubes are still intact, and for instance add different molecular complexes and bond them to the outer cells, which are more reactive once they've been broken, and change the properties of the film this way while still having the inner cores intact, which would give the high electrical conductivity and mechanical strength for the membrane. Another way to modify the network is to control the bundle size. Bundle size means how many carbon nanotubes are sort of stuck to each other. So in these images, we have a similar amount of carbon on the in the image, but it's just that here on the left side we have smaller bundles, so less CNT stuck to each other, and the right side higher bundle size, so more CNT stuck to each other. And this way you can control the open area and surface area of the carbon, and this can be important, for instance, in certain filtration applications. Another way to alter our film morphology is orientation, like a horizontal orientation. This we can do in our deposition process. On the left side, you can see a CNT network that is just randomly oriented. And on the right side, you can see a CNT network that is oriented in one direction. And this way you can, for instance, control the electrical conductivity in a way that the electrical conductivity is more in one direction and less in the other direction. Finally, the last method that I will explain in this presentation is coating. So these CNTs and CNT properties can be further altered by coating them with different materials like inorganic and organic materials, and by different means such as ALD process. In here, in this picture, you can see our carbon nanotube, single wall carbon nanotube with a conformal inorganic coating. And if you develop this idea further, you can consider that we can have like several coatings on the top of each other, coatings of different materials, and this way you can start to make like nanoscale components and devices. For instance, this could be the next generation transistor structure after silicon, and this kind of carbon nanotube transistor could have far superior properties than silicon-based transistor. Finally, a few words about our manufacturing and production. So with our freestanding film manufacturing setup, we can produce various different sizes and shapes and thicknesses. And as you heard earlier, different kind of CNT structures. And also different frame materials. So like metal or plastic or glass or silicon frames. There are various different possibilities and opportunities. And it is also important to note that this is not just a laboratory exercise, but rather we have a 3,000 square meter factory in Finland where we can produce these freestanding films as well as our transparent conductors. We have been in mass production since 2015 with these automotive products, and with freestanding films for semiconductor industry, we started mass production this year. And our production as well as R&D operates in clean room. And also we have a lot of room for further expansion in our facilities, so we can expand the capacity as per the needs of the market. So this is what I had in mind today, and I want to thank you for your attention, and feel free to contact me. I would be happy to discuss further how our technology could help you in your projects and in your applications. Thank you.